Hello Xbox viewers, we're going to go into a couple of things here, real simple here. The issue is I'm playing music and adding music to your Xbox, okay? The issue was that music will not play in order even if it's ripped off the CD. You know, the little cross marks, see all these numbers in front of this? We're going to go back to the beginning. See these little cross marks? It doesn't work properly. It just scatters the music to the wind. Okay, when they're in a straight line like that, it shuffles them. When they're this way, it plays correctly. So essentially, we go to the hard drive where I have all my music stored, and I have either albums, artists, saved playlists, or songs. So I generally now I just play songs because it messes everything up there as well. I've complained about it to Microsoft. They don't fix it. Now, as you can see, what I have done here is I've actually put the CD number with the track number. Now the other issue is with Xbox, and I'm sure this is going to be transferred right into the Xbox One, is when you put 9 and then you put a 10, it doesn't do that. It takes this 10 and moves it right to the beginning of the list. Okay, so in order to stop that, what you have to do is you have to put 1- and a letter preceding the number. Now if you have two CDs like I do in the wall here, because this is the wall, I labeled it like A10, A11, A12, A13, and then I went to the second CD and I did the same thing. B10, B11, B12, B13. Okay, now you need to do this because some music on the wall continues. Okay, here's another such case. We're going to go down here and we're going to find momentary lapse of reasoning. Here's signs of life where you hear the canoe rowing. Then it goes into this song. Okay, then you got the Dogs of War, which has no connected song, or One Slip is not connected either. Okay, on the Turning Away, yet another movie, and the Machine Part 1, and Terminal Frost, and New Frost. See that, how it all connects? These all need to be in correct order, or the whole album sounds screwed up. That's why I have MLR-A10 to put that at the end and not up there before the 1. I also have that with some Beatles music because it takes the Beatles and does the same thing. We're going to go up here and we're going to look for the BTLS. Okay, that's in the B's right up here. Here it is, BTLS. Okay, 4, 7, 8 and A14, A15, A16, and A17. These songs right here, A through 14, 14 through 15, all need to be played together in a row, right after the other, or it's messed up. Okay? The rest of the songs, I'm still sorting out. I'm going back through and renaming those, okay, so I can fix those, okay? Now, you say, well, G Common, how can you fix these? Okay, well, what you do is you go to System Music Player, Hard Drive, and then at that point you can select, if you select songs, okay, you can go in here. I want to make sure the music's not playing. Okay, you can go over here and you can rename and edit any one of these. Okay, just by going here, I'm going to click on the Sandman. Okay, that's from the America album, okay? That doesn't matter what order it's in. You see how I can edit the song info? Right there, I'm a History of America's Greatest Hits. Okay, this is the B-52s, and another, and Rough Boy, and Russians. Okay, so we have a lot of different music here, okay? That's from another album, okay? As you can see. And then we got Cirrus Instrumental, which I still, that probably belongs somewhere else in a song. Okay, so I'm going to have to listen to that and see if that fits somewhere else, because that doesn't make sense there. It seems to belong to something, you know? I have two Soak Up the Suns. So this one was dated 2003-20. This one, we want to get rid of this one, okay. As you see, we got rid of Soak Up the Sun there. We got rid of a duplicate on Soak Up the Sun now. So this is how you can manage your music right here, okay? This is very simple and straightforward. Say you want to add some music. When you put a CD in, it's going to say current CD. You're going to click on current CD. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw a CD in here real quick, and that's going to pop up, okay? And this is how you can add music, okay, to your Xbox. Now I'm going to back out of this, and I'm going to go back into this right here, and I'm going to say go to the right, System Music Player. You see that where it says current disc? Okay, now I have a couple of options. I can play the CD. Okay, or I can rip the CD. Okay, now if I go over here to rip CD, I have all these songs. You see this right here? That's just that simple. I can uncheck items that I don't want, okay? And I could rip something. So what we're going to do is we're going to rip this here. Come Together, okay? Let's say rip CD, and now Come Together is going to be put on the Xbox. And if you notice, it says CD Abbey Road. Now, if we go back over here, we go to the hard drive, which we're going to do. System Music Player, hard drive, songs. We don't want any music to play there, so what we do is we want to back out here. And we can look in here and we could here, Abbey Road is in here twice. See that? So what we can do here is we can edit the album, okay? Edit album, and we can turn around and we can put in today's date, okay? Because I just added Come Together to it. And I guess it is September 11. So we're going to say 9. Slash 11 slash 2014. And then we're just going to save the changes. Okay, now the now what we've done is we've edited the album album info, and we could go back here and we could go back together and we will see that the music is all here as well. You see, here's some other songs here. Octopus's Garden, I Want You, She's So Heavy, Sun King, Mr. Mustard, okay, Mean Mr. Mustard. That was some of the stuff that was on the album there, okay? It already existed, okay? I hope this helps out in you getting music on your Xbox and editing music. Okay, there is one other thing that I have done. As you see, I have put a 1-1 and everything else. That is the track number and the CD number, including an A in front of the 10, to keep the numbers in order. If you don't do that, they're going to be all out of order. And thank you for Microsoft for not listening to me when I told you that this didn't rip CDs in order and it mixed up the songs. Thank you very much.